This is Frost TV Africa, where big stories live. Welcome to another episode of Tea Time, as we bring you the biggest intimate stories and definitely analyze them for you. My name remains Elsie Godwin, and I have my co-anchors with me, Ife Omai and Ife Olua Oshoke.
Yes, that's me.
Hello.
How long did you practice that move? And unfortunately, the camera was not on you. So
unfortunately, it wasn't.
Now it's a white shot. So if it was on a single you, now we'll get the vibe. But you just wasted a cool move. But trust me, guys, the move was nice. Yeah.
We'll try it at the comms.
You have to speak to the camera guy to
give you a hint.
Yeah.
I feel so bad, man. I put my all into that.
How long did you try it out?
Just, you know, it just came to mind.
You went to the mirror in the glam room,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, like I had to do it. I even wore powder for it.
Oh, wow. Okay, cool. Don't be fooled, kid. Most of these cats are dead broke. They blew their lean change on jewelry, rented terrace houses, sneakers and drugs. COVID is a bastard. Now we know who saved for the rainy day. This is coming from Nigerian rapper Ilblaze. So I don't know how we now turn the entertainers to cats, but that's where
anyway,
we are.
Anyway, I wanted to let you know that he's a saver. That's good. Good for you, sir.
Mm-hmm. Is that all?
That's all, Abby. Because I don't think there's anything specific to the industry. I think it's really a relationship with money. He's just trying to tear people down. I'm not really feeling it. I don't think.
It's a global pandemic. Nobody envisaged this to come. Yes, it's good to have a saving culture, but at the same time, you don't need to tear people down. So I agree with
you. How did he tear people down? And he tore cats down, please. He did not mention anybody's name.
And aside that, what he's also saying is stating the obvious, because we all know that everybody is affected by this global pandemic one way or another. Some people didn't even think it would stay this long. Mm. So some people may have had money for the first 2 months, and right now they are now broke. So it doesn't mean they didn't save, but they've exhausted their savings as well, and right now they're broke.
I get what he's saying, because you know there are people that before we say Jack on social media, they tell us go and work, you're broke. Everybody that is on social media that is not thinking the way they are thinking, or it being yes men and women for them, they are all broke, they are jobless, because they can afford 10 naira internet. That's why they are talking to you anyhow. So if those other people are on that table as well, please shade them and call them names. Don't just call them cats.
So please name names. Name names.
No, he wouldn't do that. That would be down putting people down. I don't think he's putting anyone down. Like if I said, I think he's just trying to talk about the savings culture, and he has not really done a good job in that regard. But yeah, I think that's what he's trying to do.
Shout out to you, please, Mr. Saver.
Oh, wow.
Life Saver.
It seems you were...
Screensaver. Don't leave me.
Gosh.
Don't worry. I didn't mean to throw you a balance. You can go on now.
Please, can we move on to the...
She's looking at me like, I wish I could just cross and slap this young man.
I need to be a Taoma in your life. But it's okay. Moving on. Nollywood star Ada Kal laments over inability to use online services from Nigeria. From her Instagram post, she says she's finding it difficult to access half of her daily activities because she's in Nigeria. Quote, "This is what legit people like us have to go through because of many crooks who have spoiled our name." End of quote. Yeah, I mean, I felt this type of, I'm still feeling it.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, the biggest one is the blow that PayPal does not work in Nigeria. Mm. And if you have to do some
certain services,
kind of services, that's the best one for you. And
the one that hurts my feelings before I got engaged was dating sites. You can't get on certain dating sites.
You are engaged,
you know what I mean when I say engaged.
I'm
now in a faithful relationship. Faithful. That's what I mean. Yeah, very faithful relationship.
This is where is the kiss.
So, yeah, you can't get on certain dating sites as well just because you're in Nigeria. So that is really disturbing as well.
I find it a bit unfair, though. I think that even when you look at the figures, it is hard not to think that this is some type of, you
deliberate.
Know, yeah, kind of like a racial thing, because America still has one of the highest people who deal with online fraud.
They do, actually.
Even in Africa, we're not the highest either. There's a lot of Asian countries that are fantastic.
We're learning
about that. So I don't know what it is that makes them... if you're just going to claim that it's because we have a few bad eggs, I feel like it's not enough reason, and there has to be some type of racial play in regards to that, because there's a lot of reasons why you should give Nigerians visas. If you compare like the good things that we have done in terms of adding to people's economy, and then compare these the differences between that and like a few people who have stolen it, I'm not saying that. I'm not trying to justify it, but like it's not enough reason to like
to
you know
blacklist
yeah.
Nigerians.
And if anything, we travel a lot in comparison to a lot of people in Africa, and then we add to people's education. Like a lot of us are in school when we go abroad. Mm. A lot of people get good jobs.
And we
good
do
jobs.
Well.
We don't do sweeping and cleaning. We actually want to be in like industries and stuff. So adding money. So you cannot tell me that that's enough reason, one hush puppy or 10 hush puppies. It's not in comparison to like the millions and millions of people that have done something. So I feel like these brands, the organizations, and also embassies of countries and stuff need to start to rethink that, because there is a market here. And I understand, yes, there's infrastructure problems. And I know Apple Music had that problem when they came at first.
I hear you. But if you were there, and because you're Nigerian, you can't use those services, it's a different ballgame entirely. But why they kind of block Nigerians is because they notice that they get hacked a lot from this part of the world, or they get a lot of people trying to get into trying to use certain services from this place. And when they do, they are usually fraudulent activities.
I don't think,
do
yeah, but it's about fraud as well. I think it's also something that has to do with the banking regulations and how it works for them and doesn't work for them sometimes. Because if you also check, even the banks that claim that you can use their card to purchase things online, sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not working. And when you call them, they really don't have any explanation to give you.
I don't think it's that bad.
They need to really sort what the issue, especially for financial, what's the word now? Transactions is just really crazy. I don't know, because you cannot say that we are the only ones, Nigerians are the only ones that know how to hack, or they are the only ones that try to hack. You know, so it's been a long conversation, and I just hope that, like Ife said, they can rethink and understand that they cannot punish millions of people because of what maybe 10, 20 people did. I mean, that's
called the
just,
name. That's our biggest.
He's not the only one.
Yeah, but he's our biggest guy right now.
I mean,
like,
Amazon works
everybody's
here.
Everybody's talking about
I mean,
about
you have to go through a lot of lengthy checks. Amazon works here. So, again, I don't buy the story that people try to hack us more. People, like, if you want to do it, if you really...
You will.
You will.
You know what?
You'll
Amazon,
be able to do it.
Amazon, you know a lot of companies
AliExpress
don't
works
have...
Here.
The,
AliExpress
yeah,
works
some
here.
Of, yeah, you see
when they want to collect your money,
Amazon,
AliExpress, to work.
Those people build very strong firewalls. They have the resources.
So PayPal
has enough resources to build a strong firewall.
Well, I can't speak for PayPal, but I can tell for certain smaller services that really cannot afford those.
We don't really
extra,
want small
extra.
Services. We don't want H&M and Fashion Nova. We want, like, PayPal, for example, is huge.
It's
like,
huge.
That is really restricting to, especially
sure
to, if you want to take your business.
Even if
you're
talking about just digital
sure
marketers
PayPal.
And influencers and having to promote things on Facebook, on Instagram and co. I mean, being able to access.
It really limits you.
I'm sure there was a time PayPal
Google.
Was working, though, because I know I use PayPal in Nigeria. I can't say when precisely. But I know I used
to. There was
PayPal
a time it was working
yeah,
and then it stopped
it
again.
Working,
yeah,
so
they blocked again.
I'm sure it's for a reason. So they probably have the good.
Nobody's saying it's not for a reason. We're saying whatever the reason is, sort it out and stop making us feel like we are the blacklisted
people. If it's affecting
people
their business,
in the world.
Man, you can't advise people to keep putting their business
it's
at risk.
It's just that they can't be bothered if there's a lot of people disturbing them. I'm very sure that every country that they are.
And I'm sure it's only
established
it's not
in,
just Nigeria.
It's not
that is
as bad. Like I said, Nigeria doesn't even have the highest. So it's impossible that we are the most difficult person that you have to deal with. So
and
they're dealing
can't
with difficulties.
Be the only blacklisted
they just can't be bothered. Maybe it's because
we're
the naira isn't
Nigeria,
even
though.
Even that much for them. Like maybe if you compare the struggle and then the profits, maybe I don't know.